we sell. Now, this has got to be the strangest product I've ever shown on television, but as odd as it might sound, it could actually end up being the most useful product you've ever owned. It's called the emergency bra. That's right, I'm holding a bra. It was invented by a doctor who came up with the idea after witnessing the devastating effects of the Chernobyl nuclear plant disaster in 1986 and the September 11th attacks. What could they have to do with a bra? Well, let's hear about it. Welcome from Chicago, Dr. Lena Bogner, who joins us now to tell us how it works. Doctor, thank you so much for being here. So, bottom line is, it doubles as a face mask, correct?
Correct.
How does it work?
It actually doubles as a two face mask.
Okay, well, because there are two sides to most bras. I'm going to take it apart. It has, in addition to, of course, the two cups, it has in the middle a device, a little clip-on that separates the two halves. Then you take one half and you clip it on to the side of the same half like that. I'm not actually going to put this on, although you can see how it works. It then becomes a face mask. Maybe you can demonstrate how the mask itself works. Go ahead.
Well, as you just mentioned, David, it has two closure systems on front and on the back of the bra. So when you unhook the front and unhook the back, you basically end up with two equal parts here. And next step is by repositioning shoulder strap from connector to the bra's body strip and repositioning it in the additional hook, red hook, on the rim of cup, you can build an around head.
That's the part that goes around
it's
the head. Okay.
Adjustable.
All right. Now, let me cut to the chase here, because I'm thinking of Chernobyl. I mean, that was a nuclear accident. It had radioactive particles. Is this really going to be effective against radioactive particles?
Yes. Actually, against inhaling radiation dust, it's going to work. And as you know, as control for sense of disease recommendation for radiation protection in such of emergencies is actually to use piece of cloth folded so it would be multi-layer, preferably wetted, and close your airways.
I can understand, like, you know, a situation down in 9/11 with all the dust that was in the air, the particles being kept out, but actual radioactive dust, that's extraordinary that it can keep
right.
Whatever gave you the idea of doing this, Doctor?
Well, I just started my professional career as a medical doctor back then, and as a young medical graduate student, I participated in evacuation and relocation process of children from contaminated zone and later treating people from contaminated zone. So this experience made me realize two things. First, that specialized protective devices, highly effective, such as military-grade respirators, they are not available to the general public in case of such of emergencies.
Yeah.
And another thing, which is important, as you mentioned, that inhalation of radiological particles is a huge contributor to internal radiation dose, and
sure.
That's what happened in Chernobyl. So basically, I thought about necessity of very simple, very easy to use, and very important, always readily available personal protective devices.
Well, let me just, we got to run, Doctor, but it sells for $29.95, and I guess you're selling thousands of them, right?
Right, it's available on ebibra.com through website, more sizes, more color designs coming, and even more kinds of protective devices, convertible, are on the way.
All power to you, Dr. Lena Bogner. Thank you very much for coming in. Appreciate it. I never would have guessed. Coming up on deck, Obama gets myth busted.